My name's Jeff Tiedeken, from New Ulm, Minnesota, age 24, and I'm a prototyper, welder, fabricator. Right now, have my own company, Monkey Like Shiny, and then I also work for a company called CVM, short for Creative Viewpoint Machinery. They do projects for the government, for Clorox, all kinds of companies. I think welding is probably like the coolest thing, just because it's all about like very, very precise work, and it's a good test of your skills, both in like your hands, your eyes, your feet. Everything has to work synced together. A lot of times people come in the door and they don't even have an idea like what they need, they just have a problem. So the first thing is to understand the problem.
Like part of the sphere?
Yeah.
And it sucked to it. Too much surface contact.
Is it just gonna be one straight stick, or are you still gonna have holes in it?
Yeah, I'm gonna have holes.
Then once we know we have to make something, we usually, it'll sit down with an engineer and we'll kind of try to problem solve and figure it out. And then also, it's my job then to actually go out in the shop and build it. I think being a prototyper is kind of a generic term, because really when it comes down to it, you're like a jack of all trades but a master of none. So you basically have to be a machinist, you have to be an engineer, you have to be a fabricator, you have to be a welder, you have to be an assembler to make it all happen and do it in a timely fashion. I started my whole kind of career, like interest more in bicycles, and I knew a few people that were into, you know, building bicycles, hand building bicycle frames and like things like that. And that kind of led into me wanting to go to school to be a welder. And I went to school in Cleveland, Ohio at the Lincoln Electric Welding School, and went straight for my aerospace license, which is pretty much the pinnacle. It means you can weld for NASA, it means you can weld for Lockheed, you can weld for Boeing, you can weld for like all the big major like aerospace companies. The main thing is these guys that probably are in the age of like mid 40s all the way to like 65, 70 years old, those guys are like kind of at the end of their career, like they're trying to get to retirement and get out of it, or health problems or whatever. So it's basically left this gap of American welders and American machinists and fabricators. If you want to like kind of follow up on the career path of like a prototyper or like a fabricator, time management's key. Just knowing all those like little things, you know, knowing how to like do equations and knowing how to, you know, understand, you know, laws of physics and miscellaneous things. You just need to be a good, well-rounded person. I have the best job, because at the end, I get to hold the part and be like, I made that.